Here we are. So I'm very happy to end this virtual conference with the state of the dolphin. Usually we start with, so it's nice to close with it. I hope there are still some people listening, or they will watch later. So the first slide, it's a very known slide during our MySQL Oracle presentation. So it's a safe harbor statement. So yeah, it's there. When you have the slides, please read it carefully. So who am I? I didn't change since this morning for the people who are here this morning. So my name is still Frédéric Descamps. If you have questions during the live show after, I don't know if we won't have really time on the keynote, but I will spend some time on the Slack to answer it. If not, you can reach me on Twitter at Lefret. So I'm MySQL evangelist working in the MySQL community team. I managed MySQL for a long time already. And I'm a DevOps believer living in Belgium. We had several Belgians today during the event, so it's cool. And I have a blog, lefret.be, where you can find a lot of information related to MySQL. So where are we in MySQL in 2020? If I need to give a number, it's 8.022. So 8.022 came out on Monday. So it's very, very recent. I'm not sure that everybody already tested it. I know Marco is testing it right now. So this is for the release. You saw in the previous talk about where is the ranking in the DB Engine 2020 survey. So MySQL is the most popular open source database. And so we are very happy on that. And last year we got the DBMS of the Year award. So also something very important for us. Other than that, MySQL, it's also the most popular database with the developers. So it's something very, very important and where we are very, very proud. So we are happy to be on top there. And as you may know already, in 2020, MySQL celebrate its 25th anniversary. So we are there for a long time and let's hope for the next 25 years too, right? So as I told you, MySQL it's 8.022 since Monday, but the major release number is 8.0. So an 8.0 was a very a giant leap for SQL. So this is not me telling it, but this is a modern SQL, right? And this is when we came out, what they said about it. And as you could see, we had some gap in SQL standard support. And with 8.0, we wanted to bring all this standard and this feature to MySQL. And so when it came out, it was like this, but you can see also that we are still improving in MySQL 8. So we are still innovating all that. And we add new stuff all the time to support new standards. And you will see, I will show you later that we are still doing that in the new releases. So the developers were looking for common table expressions and recursion. So what we did, we imported, we supported in MySQL 8, the CTEs, right? So this is something new in MySQL 8. So for people not knowing about MySQL 8, so this is the right time to know that we support that, because you should be very surprised about all the thing I heard about MySQL all the time. So this is a nice recap that yes, we have a recursion common table expression support in MySQL. Lateral was also something we were missing, and we have that in MySQL. And as you can see, this was not the first release of MySQL, but in 8.0.14 it came out for analytics. So Windows function, we also support that in the MySQL 8. So this is an overview of how it works. And JSON table, this is also something, as you can see, that was in MySQL 8, this time very quickly, compared to other open source database. So we're very happy on that. And so it allows you to deal with JSON documents, like if it was a relational table. And something also new in 8.0.21, like I said earlier, we are still innovating here. It's that we have for now JSON value function. And this function is from the SQL standard 2016. And it is also implemented in other, I would say, licensed databases, but not yet in other open source database. So we are still innovating in this support of SQL. If you were this morning to my talk, you may have seen that MySQL 8 is also a document store, JSON document store. And I won't talk too much about that because I had a completely session related to that earlier this morning. And so I invite you to see that. But something you need to, very important, is that you have with the MySQL 8 document store, you have SQL, NoSQL together. You can play together with them and you can do SQL statement, but also CRUD operation on JSON document or CRUD operation on relational table. So yes, we support CRUD operation like this. So it is completely possible. And there are some examples this morning to use MySQL without a single line of SQL. This is really possible. And so these are some examples, or you can deal with NoSQL documents inside MySQL. And as you can see here is the shell in JavaScript mode, for example. So more than ever, NoSQL plus SQL, it's MySQL now. So I really engage you to test MySQL 8 as a document store if you are looking for quick development with modern language application. But MySQL 8, it's also a refactoring of MySQL. So we have, for example, this new Volcano iterator. So it's a completely new iterator for the optimizer that it's completely modular. It's very easy. When I say easy to extend, it means easy to extend for our developers. And each iterator, they can encapsulate each other and they do only one operation. And they can't interact to each other. So it's all these operations can be connected. So this is something very important for us. And this is why you see the flames here. And thanks to this new iterator, we were able to bring you some new stuff. And one of the new stuff that came out with the new iterator, for example, is the new format for the explain command. So we have explain format equal 3. And this format, it's more, let's say, more known by other in other databases than the one we were using in tables previously. So this is a format more known for different DBAs. For example, me that has always been a MySQL DBA, I really like the old one and it took me some time to get used to this one, but this one is very nice. And because of this, so, and because of the iterators can all do modular and go in each other, we bring something also that a lot of people were expecting in MySQL, is the explain analyze. So now we have explain analyze support in MySQL 8, meaning that you can have the query execution plan with all the cost, the estimated cost of a query, but also because it will run the query, also the exact actual execution statistics you have. So like the time of return row, first row, the last row, all that, how many loops, you can see all that in the explain analyze. So this is an output of explain analyze, how it works. And as you can see, we have here the actual time to get the first row. So there was the estimation and now we have the real time to it and all the time to get all of the row and how many rows and the loop, all that it's in the explain analyze. So every time you're gonna report a bug or if every time you want to do query optimization, please also add the explain analyze output. This is very helpful for us. Other than this, and also thanks to the new iterator, we have hash join support in MySQL 8. So this hash join, it's a hybrid hash join that allows us to use memory and spill to disk when necessary. And it's used in all type of join and it will replace the block nested loop in the query plan that we had before, because this one, it's much faster. And when there is no indexes available, this is the best. So here is some comparison between hash join and block nested loop when there is no indexes available. And as you can see, this is much faster. So we have done this in MySQL 8, but we have also worked on the performance and scalability. We had to know Toe because he likes to go on live events from Dimitri. So let me talk about that very in a small chapter. But we did some stuff in InnoDB and we keep doing a lot of stuff in InnoDB, but also in the binary logs. And I wanted to point some latest change that we have done that maybe people haven't tried yet or didn't know about it. So for example, we have the redo logging in MySQL that can now be disabled. So you can enable or disable, by default, of course, it's enabled because we are ACID compliant, and this is very important. But you can also say, oh, I want to disable the redo lock now. So why would you do that for an initial data load? So because if it fails for any reason that your system crash, you will just do the load again, right? So you don't need to do this all in a DB recovery, and that makes stuff much faster. Also, we have a new double write buffer that is 15 times faster, for example. This is graphed from Dimitri. So this is something we have changed in InnoDB. We also add something that was, let's say, requested from our community and a lot of people that we bring in MySQL 8, or was the bin lock compression. So bin lock compression was very important for users and customers. And this is why we have this. So thank you for Jesper for this. This comes from Jesper's blog about some, benchmarking data about that. So binary lock compression, it's also something very, very important. And you can see it can save a lot of disk space. And finally, something I really, really like, it's the MySQL clone. So MySQL clone is the fastest and easiest way to provision replicas, part of replica set or part of InnoDB cluster group replication. If you want to populate a new server from data from an existing running server, clone is the fastest way. Of course, it needs InnoDB. So this is something I really, really like. And if you don't know about it, I encourage you to have a look at it. Something that was also, and it's still very, very important for us, is the usability. So we are trying to improve all the time usability and to provide that to our users. And one of this thing we have added, for example, in 8.0.22 is to have the error log available in performance schema. So I don't know if you already saw this, but in 8.0.22, you are able to check all the error log messages in the performance schema. So no need to get in the error log file and dig into it. So when you are using cloud, this is very, very easy, right? And yeah, you have some subsystem and you can check, filter out, filter on date, on subsystems, on whatever you want. And this is, for example, oh, it looks like. So this is something was also a lot of demand on that. And I think it's very nice. Something very new also, maybe you're not yet aware about it, is the source connection auto failover. So in MySQL 8.0.22, there is this new asynchronous connection failover mechanism to automatically establish an asynchronous, so a replica to a new source if this source just crash, right? So there are several UDF to see what's going on there. And there is a table that allows you that. So you populate that table with potential source, and automatically, if the source crash, you will see the replica will join another one. So this is also something that I think will be very nice for people to play with, and I'm waiting for feedback on you on that. And like we want usability, much more easy for everything, we also want to have the full solutions easy to deploy. And this is something you may already know from me. It's the MySQL InnoDB cluster. So in MySQL InnoDB cluster, it's a single product from MySQL to provide HA and scaling feature. So you can scale your reads. There was already a talk from Marco earlier on that. And that all it's included in a end-to-end solution and very easy to use. So this is how it looks like. It has a different component like the MySQL server with group replication and clone, and you have the shell to orchestrate all that and routers to connect from the application. So it allows you to have this all HA distributed MySQL database with fault tolerance, automatic failover. You can do active-active, but with some limits that if you want to know, we can discuss that later. It has also all this membership management automated, like if one node is, has issue for the network, it will be added, it will be removed from the group. If there is some network partition, it will handle it automatically. There is this conflict detection and resolution when you are writing on multiple nodes, and it prevents from data loss. So, and of course, it's GPL, completely GPL for all components. In 8.19, we also introduce for people that has, let's say, bad network or wants to have limited resources and using less amount of servers, we have also replica set. Replica set are, it's like the standard MySQL replication, asynchronous replication that everybody knows, but much easier to use, because when we came out with the InnoDB cluster, people were amazed about how easy it is to orchestrate with the shell. And so we had a lot of people asking, but can't we use the same way, the same admin API to do a normal asynchronous replication? So I don't need to always go in the manual to know exactly how it works. And of course, yes. And this is what we have in since 8.19. So we have this MySQL InnoDB replica set that it integrates the router and it integrates also MySQL shell and provision the data through clone also like InnoDB cluster. So very, very easy. And this is something that people really like. And to be honest, I forgot how to set up a replication since I'm using the replica set. Right? The thing is that with replica set, not everything it's automated because the switchover needs to be done manually, because like there is no let's say membership like you have in InnoDB cluster. If the source dies, then it won't automatically promote one of the replica. You need to do that manually for you, because we are using, for example, two server, not three. So the rules of three here is very important and stuff like that. So all what group replication provides you, we don't have in asynchronous replication. So you need to do some manual steps. So like I said, our goal was to have one product, which is MySQL, and all the components are developed together. They are fully integrated together. They are all tested together. And to have only one client to deploy all that with the shell. So the shell can be used for both solution and with a managed server. So all the architecture that are supported by MySQL, you can have InnoDB cluster or replica set into it. So Linux, Windows, OS X, Solaris, all that. And in 8.19, we support also DNSSRV with our connectors. So if you are looking for DNSSRV, our connectors can do that since 8.19, all the connectors that we published and we support. So like I said, it's easy to deploy. So if you never saw how to do that, here are some examples on how to deploy an InnoDB cluster and how to deploy an InnoDB replica set. So you connect to one server. If you have a cluster, you just say, oh, I want to create a cluster, and you provide a name. If you want to create a replica set, you just say, okay, DBA, create replica set, and the name of replica set. DBA is for the admin API object, global object in the shell. And as you can see, I'm using JavaScript here. You could do that in Python if you want. And after, you can say, oh, there is another machine, and I want to configure that machine. So you do DBA configure instance, and it will configure everything to be part of an InnoDB cluster for group replication. And for an asynchronous replication, you do configure replica set instance, because the configuration, it's a bit different. And then you just add it using cluster add instance or replica set add instance, and you add a new node, and it will do the provisioning automatically with the clone. So you don't have to care about the data there. All it's done automatically from here. And of course, you can bootstrap the router using exactly the same commands. So you bootstrap connecting to one of the nodes, you do MySQL router bootstrap, and it will configure the router using the metadata that it's located in MySQL. So we have this architecture. If you want to see a summary, right? If you have a single region and you have your recovery time objective, it's hours, and your recovery point objective are minutes, then just MySQL server with backups, where binary lock synchronization, it's enough. Now, if you really want to have, for example, I think the latest point in the single region, like RTO sequence and RPO zero, very important, then InnoDB cluster is the answer. For multi-region, you can have multi-region InnoDB cluster, watch out of your latency, and or use a replica set depending on what you are looking for. So as you say, I was using the shell to deploy all that, because for us the shell is also very, very important. So if you have followed the MySQL 8 history, you can see that we put a lot of effort in the shell, and for us is the best DBA tool. It has a lot of utility when you try to do the upgrades, when you want to dump a lot of stuff. And you can also, it's very extensible. So you can write your plugins if you want. These are some examples of plugins created. For example, this one is very nice. You can see the logs. So you use a one thread and say, oh, I want to see a log for that are the metadata logs and the data logs that has this query or this thread, and you can see that. So in 8.0.22, we extended the framework to make it even more easy to create your plugins. And all the plugins that you can find on my repository on GitHub are now compatible with 8.0.22. Take a look if you want to create your own plugins. There is a bunch of examples there. There is a bunch of plugins that you can use, and you can create some wizard, for example, for junior DBAs. So there is a lot of, it's endless, it's a potential of the shell. Something also very important for us is that since September, MySQL Database Service is available in OCI. So there is now a completely managed service in OCI that is completely developed and managed by the MySQL team. It's built on MySQL Enterprise Edition. So when you use MDS, you have the Enterprise Edition. And it's completely compatible with on-premise MySQL and compatible with Oracle technologies like the Vault and stuff like that. And like I said, it's completely supported by the MySQL team. So it's very easy, it's secure, and it's enterprise ready, of course. So if you are looking for a service in the cloud, please take a look at MDS. We are very happy to have launched that in September. And as you can see, it can reduce cost. And if you are looking for a free tier, I can also point you to that. And we are deploying it, and it's still in deployment. So every month we deploy MDS in different region. And these are the region now in October, right? Now, something very important for us in the MySQL team, I would say, and in Oracle, it's Black Lives Matter, right? So this is why we decide to change the terminology. So if you followed my talks or talks from other MySQL and Oracle engineers, you could say that we don't use anymore some offending terms. So and we decide to change this terminology, not only in blog posts, not only in slides, but also everywhere. So meaning in the comments, in the output, in the manuals, even in the source code, everywhere we want to get rid of this term. Of course, this is a huge amount of work, and we will distribute this work in several releases to not have one release only on that and not continue the current work, right? So if you are looking for information, please check on Kenny's announcement. You can find it here. And you could see, for example, already some changes in 8.0.22. So now the commands like show replica status, that it's there. And if you are using the old terminology, you would have a warning that says this terminology will be deprecated in the future. So this was very important, and I wanted to tell, and we are changing that everywhere. Also something, this is very important and some could surprise some people here in this audience, but we had an event last week, and this is a question that always come to us is about the license of MySQL and is MySQL open source. So yes, MySQL is GPL and open source. MySQL server is GPL, the router is GPL, the shell is GPL, clone is GPL, workbench is GPL, all that is GPL, and we also accept contributions. So for example, in MySQL 8, we had 283 contributions from 68 different contributors, and the employees are not counted. And our top three contributors are currently Facebook, Daniel Van Eeden, and Lorinas Bivanis. So thank you very much from them. If it was a live event, I would say please applaud them. So I will applaud alone here. So, but thank you very much to all our great contributors. And thank you very much to them. So this is the nice word cloud of our contributors. And please, when you see them, say them thanks or tweet them anything you want to say thank you. We have also a Slack channel for the MySQL community, so you can join it and you will there speak with community members like me and Dave, but also with the engineers and great DBA from around the world, or I would say just users of MySQL that can answer your question or that have a lot of questions. And as MySQL is out, MySQL 8 is out, of course, it means that there are some certifications available too. So we have the MySQL 8 database administrator certification that's available if you want to take the certification, and the MySQL 8 database developer, which are even worked on it. So I'm very happy of it. So I had some extra time, but I was able to deliver all my content very quickly. So I'm happy to that. And please don't forget, and this is important, that soon MySQL 5.6 will be end of life. So it's less than 4 months for you to migrate. And of course, I invite you to migrate to 8.0 and maybe, why not, in MDS. So thank you very much for that. If you have some question, I can answer them. I don't know if I don't see any question right now on Slack. So let me see, nothing currently. So if you have question, don't hesitate or find me on Twitter. Let me stop sharing the slides and you will see me big, not alone. So.
All right. Well, thank you so much for closing out the 28-hour marathon. It was great to have you finish us off really strong, and I'm really excited in my conversations that I have with prospective clients of Percona or existing customers or just people out in the community, even old friends. I tell them that I'm really starting to feel like the latest release of MySQL is the best MySQL that's existed. And for a long time, I couldn't say that, right? You'd have to say, oh, you gotta wait. But now every time a release comes out, like 22, this is the best MySQL that's ever existed. And that's something that I'm truly, truly excited to be a champion for and to say, especially at this conference. So thank you and thank the Oracle team for all their really, really hard work and everything that they've done to be, amazing stewards of the open source community.
Thank you very much.